On the day of Ashura, Shimr calls, where are our cousins, Al-Abbas and his brothers? Imam Abbas doesn't even want to answer him. Imam Hussain says, go to him, even though he's a fasiq. He's a corrupt man, but go see what he wants. He goes, he says, what do you want? He says, you are our cousins because Shimr and Ummul Baneen come from the same big tribe. So you are our cousins. Why don't you come to our side and come and join Yazid ibn Muawiyah? Why do you want to get killed next to Abi Abdullah al-Husayn? Al-Abbas looks at him and he says, may your mother have lost you, Ya Shimr. Yani may you get killed, Ya Shimr. Is that what you called me for? You want me to leave my brother Abi Abdullah al-Husayn and join you? La wallah. He turns back. This young man at the age of 36 comes back and stays with Abu Abdullah al-Husayn. He stays till the last companion. No more companions, no more family members. He was the last one left with Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, just before the martyrdom of the baby. He was the last man left. When Imam al-Husayn lost all his family members and called, هَلْ مِنْ نَاصِرٍ يَنْصُرُنَا هَلْ مِنْ مُعِينٍ يُعِينُنَا. Now at this point, he sees his brother coming to him. أَخِي أَبَا عَبْدِ اللَّهِ, give me the permission to go and fight. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam looked at him. He said, أخي أبا الفاضل, أنت حامل لوائي, كافل محملي. Brother Ya Abbas, you are the carrier of my flag. You are the carer of my family. You are my strength and my support. If Allah strengthened Musa through Harun and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi through Ali, Allah strengthened Al-Husayn through Al-Abbas salamullahi alayhi. He says, you are my strength, you are my supporter. Losing you would be catastrophic, Ya Abul Fadhl Al-Abbas. Who will take care of the women and the children? He said, brother, but I cannot have any more patience on those hypocrites, enemies of Allah, who are fighting you. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam looked at him. He said, all right, Abul Fadhl, if it is indeed a must that you have to go, then why don't you grab the water to the women, to the children of Abi Abdullah al-Husayn? Rather go to the river of Furat. When Imam al-Husayn said this, Abul Fadhl heard the children of Imam al-Husayn crying, Al-Atash, Al-Atash, uncle, we are thirsty. He looks at them. Amongst them is Sukaina, the daughter of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Uncle Abu al-Fadhl, I am thirsty. I have not had water. He looks at her. He says, don't worry, my little girl. I will go to the water. He takes the bag of water. The plan, my brothers and sisters, was for Abu al-Fadhl to go fetch the water and come back. And therefore, if you read the history, he did not bid the farewell to the women and the children. He didn't say goodbye to them. Imam al-Husayn, when he wanted to go, he said, goodbye, I'm leaving. The family members, when they wanted to go, they would say, goodbye, we are going to the battle. Abu al-Fadhl didn't say his goodbyes. He did not bid farewell to Zainab, salamullahi alayhi. He grabs the bag of water like a lion. He heads to the river of Furat. Umar ibn Sa'd had kept 4,000 men soldiers to prevent the army of Imam al-Hussein from reaching the water. When those people see Abul Fadhl al-Abbas coming like a lion, they remember him from the battle of Siffin. They remember his heroism. They remember his bravery. So they dispersed from him. They could not match him. They could not stand in his way. They got scared. He dispersed the army. He killed a few of them and they dispersed. They all ran away. They opened the path for him to reach the river of Furat. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam says, the heart of my uncle al-Abbas was burning like charcoal from thirst. He reaches the river of Furayat. He dips his hand in the river of Furayat. The enemies are watching. Is he gonna drink? He's thirsty. But they see him looking at the water and then he lets go of the water. Why wouldn't he drink? Then he recited these verses of poetry. Then they realized why. He said, Ya nafsu min ba'd al-Husayn huni fa-ba'dahu ma kunti an takuni hadha Husaynun وارد المنون وتشربين بارد المعين والله ما هذا فعال ديني ولا فعال صادق اليقين. He says, oh my soul, you're trying to drink the water. When your master Hussein is thirsty, never wallah. This is not the teachings of my religion and the teachings of my father, Amir al-Mu'mineen. Nor is this what my mother, Umm al-Baneen, advised me to do. Ana, ana, ashrab ladhidh al-may hasha. والحسين والأطفال كلهم عطاش. He fills the water, the bag with the water. Then he rides his horse. He puts the bag over his chest. He wears it. And now the bag has to arrive to be delivered to Sukayna, to Abdullah al-Radi', to Ali al-Asghar, to the children of Imam al-Hussein. He now heads to the tent. He wants to deliver the water to the family of Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. At that point, Umar ibn Sa'd, la'anahu Allah, cries, block him, for wallah, if the water reaches Hussein, you people will never be able to defeat him. So the enemies of Allah surrounded him from all sides, but they could not get near him. He was like a lion going through them, defeating them, with his main concern of reaching the water to the family and the camp of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. And the whole time he's carrying the banner up high, so Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam from a distance can see the banner is still up. يعني يا أبا عبد الله, I will not let go of your banner. Until the enemies of Allah surrounded him from all sides, but they couldn't get near him. So then one of the enemies of Allah hid behind a palm tree. As Abul Fadhl al-Abbas came by that palm tree, he struck him with his sword over his right hand. The right hand fell on the plains of Karbala. Everyone call, Aywa Abbasa. He took the sword with the left hand and he recited these verses of poetry. Wallahi in qata'tumu يا يميني إني أحامي أبدا عن ديني وعن إمام صادق اليقين سبط النبي المصطفى الأمين. Oh, I swear by Allah, if you cut off my right hand, this will not deter me from defending my Imam, as this is my conviction in him. It's as if he did not even feel the pain of losing his right hand. This lion took the sword in his left hand and the banner to his chest, and he continued going to the camp of Imam al-Hussein. Let me get the water to the camp. Then another enemy of Allah hides behind another palm tree. The minute Abul Fadhl crosses him, he cuts off his left hand. Aywa Abbas, aywa Sayyida, aywa Mawla. He then takes the banner to his chest like this. He keeps it. The banner has to go up. The banner has to stay up. And the bag must reach the camp of Imam al-Hussein as he recited these verses of poetry. Ya nafsu la takhshay min al-kuffari wa abshiri bi rahmati al-jabbari قد قطعوا ببغيهم يساري فصلهم يا رب حار النار. O my soul, O my nafs, O myself, do not be deterred by the enemies of Allah. O Allah, they've cut off my left hand. Punish them in the hellfire. Yet he still doesn't feel the pain. He continues his journey. The banner is still up. The bag of the water is with him. He has to get to the camp. At this point, he was showered with the arrows of the enemies of Allah. One arrow hit the bag of water and spilled all the water. That's when Abul Fadhl al-Abbas felt the pain. That's when he stood there idle. What am I gonna do? How can I go back now to the camp of Imam al-Hussein? Another arrow was shot in his eye. Another arrow hit his chest. Then one of the enemies of Allah got an iron pillar and he struck him over his head with it. At this point, Abul Fadhl al-Abbas fell off his horse and he cried for the first time. He fulfilled the wish of Imam al-Hussein. Akhi Hussein, adrikni. Oh brother Hussein, come to my rescue. Come to your brother Abbas. Imam al-Hussein, when he saw the banner now is no longer up, he rushed to his brother. He made all the people disperse, get away from him. At that point, he saw his brother Abul Fadhl al-Abbas with the right hand on one side, the left hand on another side, an arrow in his eye, another in his chest, a spear on his back. He cried, Aywa Abbas! Aywa Akha! الآن انكسر ظهري. وقلت حيلتي وشمت بي عدوي أخويا أخويا ظهري انكسر ولا أقدر Oh, brother Abbas, now I feel I have lost my army. Now it is the time when I feel that I am lonely. I am all alone in Karbala. Abul Fadhl Al-Abbas hears some footsteps. He says, oh man, if you've come to kill me, please allow me some moments. Let my brother Hussain come to me first. I would like to smell him one last time because Abul Fadhl couldn't see anymore. The blood is covering his eyes. Imam al-Hussein cried. He said, Akhi Abbas, I am your brother Abi Abdullah. He takes his head, he puts it on his lap and on his chest. Abul Fadhl picks up his head, puts it back onto the sand. Imam al-Hussein takes the head again onto the lap. Again, he puts it back on the sand. A third time, Ya Akhi Abul Fadhl al-Abbas, why do you do this? Let me hug you. Brother Ya Hussein, you are carrying my head on your chest right now, but who will carry your head in an hour from now? I wish I had a second life to defend you, Ya Hussein. Look at the loyalty of this man, subhanallah, in his final moments. Look at the bond of love. Then Imam al-Hussein says, Akhi Abul Fadhl, let me carry you back to the tent. He says, Brother Abi Abdullah, no, please leave me here next to the river of Furat. Why, brother? We carry all the family back. Ali al-Akbar, al-Qasim, your brothers, you too as well. He said, no, Ya Hussein, I promised the children to come back with the water. But how can I see them with an arrow in my eye? How can I hug them when I have no hands, Ya Hussein? Ah, he gave ya khoya, khalini bimichani. He gave يقل وعدت سكنة تراني أجيب الماي وللخيم أسدر And then his soul departed his body. Imam al-Hussein cried. Let's all cry three times. أيوة عباسا As loud as you can. أيوة أيوة Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam got up with his tears flowing over his cheeks. He headed back to the tent. Who is waiting? Zainab alayhi salam is waiting. She says, Akhi Aba Abdullah, where is my brother Abbas? He says, Ya Zainab, I left him on the river of Furat with no right hand, no left hand, an arrow in his eye, arrow in his chest, a spear on his back. يقلها يا زينب راح عباس عباس راح الضيغم اللي يرفع الراس She cried أيوة عباسا أيوة أخاه أيوة ضيعته بعدك صاح الحسين إي والله وضيعته بعدك أبل فضل Then remember, brothers and sisters, Abul Fadhl never bid the farewell to Zainab, salamullahi alayha. So at night when she calmed the family, the children, they saw Zainab getting up. Now that the family is rested, she made sure that they're all accounted for. Zainab, where are you going? She says, I have a farewell to make at the river of Furat. I wanna go to my brother Abbas. I wanna tell him, brother Abbas, they burned the tent that you set up for me, brother Abbas. They attacked me, they hit me, Abbas. واللون مخطوف وعضاي تتراجف من الخوف انا ردتك لحالي وللذي تشوف خويا لقيت العلم عالنار ملفوف خويا عذرتك من شفت ما عندك جفوف لا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين.